In this video, I am going to explain why mechanics of foot can affect the whole body mechanics and the whole body posture. Especially, I am going to focus on the calcaneus today. You know, calcaneus is very important bone. We humans are biped creature, right? Biped. Biped means we have to bear weight on 2 feet. Most of other animals are quadruped. Quadruped means they walk on 4 feet. I mean 2 feet and 2 arms, right? So they can spread their body weight to the 4 places, right? 2 feet and 2 arms. But human has to take body weight and the shock from the walking to the only 2 feet. That's why our calcaneus is very big compared to whole foot length. Okay? That's why calcaneus should be in place. Okay? Now, I have to talk about 3 arches. Okay? We have 3 arches on the foot. One is lateral longitudinal arch. One is medial longitudinal arch. And one is transverse arch. Calcaneus is part of lateral longitudinal arch. So if calcaneus is in the wrong position, this can aggravate arch. Why is arch so important? You know, we naturally have arches in our foot, okay? So it's like the base of the foot. It's like an architecture. You know, arch is strong structure. If you think about a building or churches or other temples, there are arch structures, right? To spread the load. So when we walk, when we jump and land, when we run, our foot has to take all energy from ground, from body weight. So our foot should be like springy, like this. If this arch is collapsed, it's like this or this, right? So this architecture is so important. Then calcaneus is part of arch. Now that sounds very important, right? If arch collapses, the compensation has to go somewhere, right? Even though our calcaneus is in the wrong position, we still has to walk, we still has to run, right? Then the compensation has to go somewhere. Maybe other foot bones, right? Or ankle joint, or knee, pelvis, hip joint, or spines. This compensation can go all the way up to the neck and head. It is very common that somebody has tight foot, they tend to have tight spines. This tendency is very, very common. Again, so calcaneus should be in the right placement. Then there are many, many muscles, ligaments, and myofascias around calcaneus. Let's say there is Achilles tendon on the posterior part, right here. On the inferior part, there are intrinsic muscles of foot. And in inside, here, there are 3 muscles pass close to calcaneus. These muscles don't attach on calcaneus, however, they pass through close to calcaneus. So these muscles balance is also important for calcaneus. What are they? Tibialis posterior, flexor hallucis longus, and flexor digitorum longus. So this is very important. If you go to the lateral part, the fibularis longus and fibularis brevis pass through here, very close to calcaneus. These 2 muscles also do not attach on calcaneus, yet this balance is very, very important. Why? Because the inside muscles and outside muscles kind of wrap around foot like this. And one side gets tight, it can aggravate balance. Okay? And one more structure. There is connective tissue around ankle joint. This connective tissue is retinaculum. Retinaculum is like a wrapping system around ankle joint. It's like an ankle supporter or sock. Okay, if this retinaculum gets tight, that can also aggravate the placement of calcaneus. Oh my gosh, it's so important. There are many, many muscles and tissues pass around calcaneus. Okay, of course, the other bones are so important, like talus, like navicular, like a cuboid bone. These bones are also important for foot mechanics, foot arches, the compensation for other joints. But if I keep talking that, this video can be forever. That's why I focus on the calcaneus today. Again, calcaneus is part of lateral longitudinal arch. If this balance is aggravated, you know, it's if it goes to like this rotational movement, see, this compensation should go to talus, then this compensation should go to tibia, fibula, the up to the knee, up to hip joint, up to pelvis and spines. That's why this is very important. Think about our foot is base of the house. If base of the house is weak or not very strong, what happens to the pillar? What happens to the roof? What happens to the wall? It has to compensate, right? Because this is the base of the body. This is the base of the house. You know, base should be solid. Base should be very, very strong for the building, right? You can say same thing for the foot. Okay, that's why calcaneus is so, so important. In this video, I explained why our foot mechanics is so important for whole body posture or whole body biomechanics. Especially in this video, I focused on the calcaneus. Again, I am not saying calcaneus is the only bone which is important in the foot. Of course, talus is important. Of course, navicular is important. Of course, cuboid is important. Other bones are also equally important. But in this video, I focused on the calcaneus. So if you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you in next video.